When I came to Purdue and I looked around, Purdue had a prestigious group working on heat transfer, and I saw the potential in terms of facilities, capabilities, and the need to grow it in the future. And that's how it all started. If you look at space vehicles, in the past they use what's called single-phase cooling systems, where you have a liquid that is passed through tubes and would extract heat from the avionics and other components in, for example, the space shuttles that are now retired. However, for future space systems, we have to reduce weight still further. And to do that, we're looking into incorporating boiling and condensation in order to reduce the size of the cooling hardware. And this is done because these processes are highly efficient in terms of heat transfer. We started a partnership with NASA Glenn Research Center. We are beginning to achieve design relations that will ultimately be tested on board the International Space Station. One of the tasks of the project that we have is to assess the influence of microgravity on boiling performance. That experiment has been on the Vomit Comet actually several times, and our students have done a remarkable job to conduct both boiling and condensation studies to assess the effect of weightlessness. When you're talking about space, everything needs to be optimized in terms of weight, volume, compatibility. Every member, structural member that you see in this facility, every screw that is used on it has to be evaluated and certified. There aren't many universities in the U.S. that are capable of conducting this type of research. It is truly exciting. It's very different from more conventional research that we perform, and I think part of the excitement stems from the great relation we have with NASA scientists and engineers. It's very unique. We have established that relation over a period of over 15 years now. And we feel we're really accomplished something very unique and very useful for future space vehicle design.